Hi everyone and welcome back to some more Long War 2. So, let's continue where we left off and keep scanning in New Australia. We got a mission coming up. Dark event complete. Alien forces filled improved combat units with a bonus hit point. Okay, could have been worse. Bonus hit point is not the end of the world. And here's the facility lead. Western US, unlocked. Okay then. What do we want to research next? I'm thinking coil guns. It's unfortunate that I'll have to spend 100 supplies to actually get started on that. But we should really get coil guns. Especially since we already had Archons popping up. We'll get coil guns and then probably powered armor. Powered armor research actually requires zellerium cores. Alright, coil guns. We need so many things right now. So, for example, I would really like to pick up... Where is it? Tactical infiltrations. I'm not sure why we can't get it right now. Special requirement. Oh yeah, we need a higher rank officer, that makes sense. Still, even if I had a higher rank officer right now, this requires 250 supplies. I could technically afford it, but there are so many other things that I also need supplies for right now. Like gear. Speaking of higher rank officers, I think we can train some of them right now. Let's have a look. Do we have one who's not actually busy at the moment? I don't think we do, they are all busy. Can we train another officer? We got three currently. A fourth one definitely wouldn't hurt. Maybe Spacebar should be an officer. The highest health person is Jory. I don't think a Grenadier officer makes a whole lot of sense. But if we want high health people, then he would be the best candidate. Six health officer makes me a little bit nervous. Because I really don't want them to die to an unlucky crit to the face. I think we'll wait for now. All the other officers seem to be busy at the moment. Avatar project, yes. Facility discovered, so there it is. We still have to make contact with that. But we can make contact directly from Australia. Well, right now, our goal is to make contact with New Indonesia, then we'll do the black side, and as soon as we're done with that, we will make contact with Western US to get rid of that facility. And to that end, we need to build a radio relay. Let's just get started on that. Speaking of spending supplies, 150 supplies. So yeah, we definitely need that. This will also make Australia more efficient. And another new mission. No, that's the mission we are doing. Okay, 129%. It was probably a bit of an overkill, but enemy readiness is down to vulnerable. And the evac time is down to 2 turns only. It will not get any better than this. And very light activity. Let's go! We can certainly use the materials. We need the materials, it's as simple as that. Also, once we are done with the regional network tower in East Africa, we'll have to send a squad to infiltrate the regional HQ. That will take a while. And it will require our best soldiers. But let's not worry about that just yet, let's worry about the mission we are in. So... the zone wall is right here, that's the corner behind us. I think we should stick relatively close to the zone wall. I don't want to engage in the middle of the map because that makes it much more likely that we'll put groups on yellow alert.
Roger that.
And we don't want that.
Eyes on a hostile patrol.
Speaking of groups, here's the first one already. We can probably engage them from here, that seems reasonable. Let's set up. Steady weapon for Bob. And... we'll move around a little bit. Towards them, slightly. Let's have a look. We can spread out slightly. They have some loot, we can definitely use that. There's not a whole lot of full cover around here.
Moving on target location.
I guess partial cover will have to do.
En route vers la position indiquée.
And James.
Rolling.
Okay, this will have to do, I suppose. Overwatch. in case they see us, which they probably won't. So, sergeant, officer, trooper. Sergeants are pretty annoying, because they have tactical sense. They don't always have tactical sense, it's a chance. This one doesn't. Okay. We should probably kill the officer then, because the officer can mark us, and he has 85 aim. But how do we want to open this? Maybe with a grenade? Maybe with cyclic fire? We could open with cyclic fire on the officer, it's not a bad idea. It does use a crap ton of ammunition, but there's a good chance we will either kill him or do a lot of damage. We can also take precision shot with Bob. 82% chance to crit. We got a guaranteed crit on the officer. I guess that will be the best opener then. It will be a crit as long as we hit him. What else do we want to do? I don't want too much Overwatch because I'd like to kill either the entire pod or at least two or three enemies. We probably won't kill the entire pod, but I will try. Yeah, I don't think I want Overwatch on anyone, basically. I see no reason to use Overwatch on these people, maybe on Bill. But I'd rather keep combat protocol as an option. Alright, let's go for Bob's precision shot on the officer. Hopefully he won't miss. He has 4% chance to miss. That would be the biggest troll ever. Aggression, steady weapon, weapon crit, dead shot. Alright, go. Yeah, without dead shot, he wouldn't have over 100%, and that's a kill. Very nice. Now let's hope we'll be able to kill the others. We can probably ignore the drone if we kill the trooper or the sergeant. The drone might stun someone, but that's not really a huge problem if we aren't fighting too many dangerous enemies. So how do we do this? If we want to kill the sergeant, we'll have to blow up his cover, which might or might not be worth it. I'm not entirely convinced that it's worth it. What's our chance to hit him? Yeah, it's kind of low. What else can we do? Oh, we could actually try to control the drone. That's probably a bit pointless, but we can shut down the drone guaranteed, 100%. So we can pretty much ignore the drone right now. Let's see, I'm just trying to figure out the best way to do it. We can obviously flank the trooper, but then we will get flanked ourselves by the sergeant. So it's not the best idea of all times. I think we should just use the grenade on the sergeant. We will still have two more plasma grenades on Zoe. Yeah, okay, this will hopefully blow up his cover. That's the general idea behind it. No, it didn't. Okay, 5 damage though. Let's see. We could use walk fire, that's 45% chance. Probably worth it. By the way, this will not count as high ground, unfortunately. As much as I would like it though, it doesn't work that way. So let's try walk fire on that guy, 45%. It might actually kill him if we do 5 damage. It's a possibility. We did kill him. Well done. Now, can we kill the trooper? I don't think so. We do have hail of bullets that can do up to 9 damage, but it's very unlikely we'll do exactly 9 damage to that guy. I don't think we should be pushing our luck. The best thing to do is just Overwatch, I think, in case he tries to move towards us. We can try to kill the drone and then use aid protocol, maybe, on someone. Then again, I think Overwatch would be slightly more effective. Huh. Well, we could use hail of bullets and then Overwatch. Can we stand in cover and then use halo bullets somehow? No, not really. No, we actually can't. Well, I guess I could stand over here. It doesn't really matter because he can move and flank someone regardless. Okay, fine, let's use hail of bullets. If we get lucky, we might actually do 9 damage. I'm not really counting on it, but we can at least do guaranteed damage this way. If we use Overwatch, we will not do guaranteed damage. And if there's a small chance we'll kill him, I'll take that chance. Just like we did with the sergeant. We did actually kill him! Okay, that was totally not my plan, but hey, that's nice. And now we can either just kill the drone or use Haywire Protocol. I would prefer to save Haywire Protocol in case we get like another group on the next turn. There, we need one more damage, literally. 82%. A Graze will also kill it. It's down. No need to use Haywire Protocol. So we killed the entire group, very nice. I wasn't really counting on it. But it's nice when it happens. Now, let's go and pick up the loot, shall we? But I will not be dashing towards it, that's a very silly thing to do.
On your order.
There might be a group on yellow alert nearby, so we have to be careful about that. We can pick up both piles on the next turn. It's fine.
On the move.
So let's move. No need to reload on Buzz. No need to reload on Nancy. And yeah, we have quite a few free reloads from autoloaders, so that's nice. Steady weapon for Bob, and Bill can probably dash to where others already are. Seems reasonable. Okay, we can pick up both piles with blue moves. So that's exactly what we'll do on the next turn. Meanwhile, we'll overwatch in case someone shows up. Yep, they did show up. Wait, what? There's a sector nearby. Okay, reanimated. Wait, all three reanimated at the same time, what? That doesn't make any sense. Okay, that has to be some kind of different enemy. Right, I still want the loot, for reasons that should be fairly obvious. So I will obviously pick it up. But I don't like these zombies. Elite laser sight, nice, that's our first elite laser sight. Is that the group that raised the zombies? No, it isn't. Okay, then. What should we do about these guys? Well, probably flashbang. We can flashbang with Zoe. I kind of want the other pile of loot, but I can't pick it up safely. At least, not entirely. What if we use a rocket launcher? We could pick up the loot and then use command. A rocket is actually really tempting, I'm not gonna lie. These zombies are a problem though. They don't have a whole lot of health, but I can't just leave them there. Yeah. Well, I want the loot. So screw it, let's pick up the loot. And then we'll see. Defense PCS, sure. So now, we could use a grenade, we could use command. I think we'll just use command. We can also flashbang, but then I'll have to do something about the zombie. Well, this is a bit of a problem. The zone wall is right here, so it's probably safe to move in this direction. Yep, let's move away from them. Bob, we got face off, which isn't super helpful in this situation. No, it kind of isn't. Let's use that rocket launcher. We could try concussion rocket, but the zombies are a little bit too spread out. We're better off using a regular rocket. Like so. We can try to hit three guys with it. Alright, let's go for it. That wasn't too bad. We only hit two, but we got crits. And we killed the Guardian. Yeah, I'll take it. Now, what else can we do? What about Bob's chance to hit on the Grenadier? He has full cover, so I don't think it will be amazing. 56%. I think we're better off killing one of the zombies. Using face-off is a bit pointless, because it will not do enough damage to kill them, while a shot with our primary weapon will kill them, guaranteed. Or at least the one that we got line of sight to. One of the two that we have line of sight to. Probably this one on the right side, because it's kind of closer to us. Alright, let's go for it. That's a guaranteed kill, unless we graze, which we won't. Now, I would still like to flashbang at least the sergeant and the gunner. But can we actually do it? Not very safely, I don't think so. I could do it with James, but the problem with that is that the zombie will definitely attack James. And the other zombie is also a bit of a problem. This whole situation sucks, these three zombies are really annoying. I'm seriously torn about what to do right about now. Bill needs to move, that much is obvious. He's being flanked. Alright, I guess we'll just move. Away from the zombies, preferably. And then what? We can try to kill the zombie, and really, that's about it. I don't think there's much else we can do. What's our chance to hit? 94%. Alright, let's just kill this one, hopefully. It's down. That leaves us with James. He can take a shot and then move, or other way around. I might just accept some damage from the zombie in order to flashbang these two guys. I don't know, I'm considering it. We could stand over here and flashbang them. I think it's worth it. I mean, James has 2 armor, 9 base health, and 2 ablative armor. The zombie won't do that much damage. So I think it's fine, let's just do that. Oh great, Sectoid Commander, that was it. Right. I wasn't even aware that Sectoid Commanders are a thing in Long War 2, I guess I know now. This doesn't really change my plan, I'm still going to flashbang these two guys. Like so. And we'll just have to do something about the Sectoid Commander on our next turn. But that's not the kind of enemy I expected at all. He might try to mind control James, which would be unfortunate. Oh, the zombie didn't even hit us. It only had 66% chance to hit from point blank range. So here comes the Sectoid. What is he using? Panicked. Yeah, that's fine. As long as James doesn't do anything stupid. The Sectoid Commander used 2 moves. Yeah, we are fine.
Thank you, body armor.
We still have to kill all of them. But we have the concussion rocket. But if I want to use that, I need to move closer. Because it seems to have more limited range. Well, I'd like to move with Buzz regardless. Let's check the range on that. It will leave some smoke behind, just something to remember. It's probably worth hitting the Sectoid Commander and the Sergeant with it. Then we can focus on other enemies. I think we should do that, yeah? Let's just do it. I wish it had slightly better range, but oh well. Will it stun the commander or the sergeant? No, it's just a chance for that to happen. Doesn't look like it even disoriented them. Alright, you tried. So, how do we do this exactly? Let's check Bob. What's your chance to hit? We still have to kill that silly zombie. 48% on the gunner. We could use rapid targeting on the gunner and then try to kill him. It's not a bad idea. Let's try to kill the gunner then. That's what we'll do. There's also a good chance another pod will attack us. The mission has very light activity, so I don't think there are that many enemies left. But there might be one more pod on yellow alert right about now. Let's try to kill the gunner. And that's 5 damage, I'll take it. It was a graze, but certainly better than a miss. And now we could actually kill him with combat protocol. So that's exactly what we'll do. Any point using interference? Not really, no. Alright, kill the heavy gunner. He will drop some loot, but it's unlikely I'll pick that up. Never say never, but it's, yeah, not very safe to go there. Now, might be nice to kill the zombie, because, you know, James is currently panicking. I don't want to move too close to the commander. I'd rather stay out of his range. So how about we do exactly that, stay out of range and kill the zombie. James is in full cover, he should be fine. Down goes the zombie. And yeah, we'll stay away with Zoe. Hopefully they will move towards us out of the smoke. Okay, sounds good. We can also use Overwatch. But I'd like to move into full cover. Zoe doesn't have the shield anymore, or ablative health, I mean. She still has 8 health, but yeah, full cover is certainly better than partial. Here comes the Grenadier, he's too far away to do anything. The Sectoid can only attack James. He will raise a zombie. Fine by me. Here comes the Commander, let's hope we'll hit him. No, we will not. He probably has defense, if I had to guess, because these guys had quite a lot of defense in XCOM 1. Mind controlled, yep. Yeah. It's not a problem though. We can throw a flashbang grenade and break mind control, that's exactly what we're going to do. So let's have a look. Who should be the one to do it? I think it should be Bill, actually. Then we can use a plasma grenade with Zoe. And that will be slightly more useful. I think there's one enemy on Overwatch in the back. But that doesn't matter, let's just move in. He's not even close enough. So, flashbang grenade. We can actually hit the sergeant. Okay. Do it! This should break mind control. Like so. Now, can we actually kill the sector commander? How much defense does it have? Let's see. Only 10, alright. I could actually hit it in the face with both barrels. That is very, very tempting. It's not exactly the safest move of all times. And it would trigger reaction shot from the Grenadier. Yeah, that's actually kind of a terrible move. It's still tempting, don't get me wrong. What's our chance to hit? 53% on the Sergeant, only 43% on the Sectoid. I think we should just take 2 shots at the Sectoid. We got 40% chance to hit with both barrels. We could also try that. Let's take a regular shot first. This is where I could really use rapid targeting. We did actually hit. So now we can either use walk fire for 83% chance to hit, or try our luck with both barrels. I think I'd rather use walk fire to do some guaranteed damage. And then we might be able to kill it with combat protocol. Yeah. If we do at least 4 damage, then we can kill it with combat protocol, which is going to be the best way to do it. And yep, we got it. And now we can kill it with combat protocol. Well, actually, hold on, we already used Bill for the flashbang. That's still fine, we can still kill it with a grenade, for example. Or we could use command for Bill and then use combat protocol. It's not a bad idea, it's not like I'll use command for anything else. It's as good use as any, really. Alright, command. That's the best way to guarantee a kill, basically, so that's exactly what we're going to do. Combat protocol and kill the sector commander. RIP. Now, we're not out of the woods yet. Let's see, Bob needs a reload. What's your chance to hit? We should probably kill that silly Psy zombie, I guess. Or we could set up with steady weapon. I'm not even sure if the Psy zombie is close enough to attack James, it might not be. Then again, it's safer to just kill it, so let's just kill it. Down it goes.
Enemy destroyed.
And I think that's pretty much all we can do on this turn. The Grenadier is on Overwatch. We can use Overwatch ourselves. I'd like to move a little bit closer.
Moving to position.
Because we need slightly better line of sight. Okay, Overwatch. Maybe move Ansi somewhere better. Like over here. I wouldn't want him to get flanked. Then again, this position won't make a massive difference. And he will lose full cover. No need to reload, we got 3 reloads. What's our chance to hit? Yeah, too low. Overwatch. Good enough. This might actually be the last group at this point. I'm not counting how many we killed. But there's probably one more pod. Let's focus on these guys for now. So, sectoid. Overwatch on the sectoid, that's fine. Sergeant. Yep, James is fine. He has full cover. So that's definitely helping. Reload. Walk fired, 60% on the sectoid. If we want to move any closer, we should probably break that overwatch. But do we really want to move any closer or just take a few shots from the back? I have to say, I'm not a huge fan of the concussion rocket right now. It's a little bit too situational for my taste. It's extremely situational.
On the move.
How about we hit these two guys with a grenade? That seems to be the best way to do some damage to them. We should actually kill the Grenadier with this. Yeah, this should be a guaranteed kill, unless we get really unlucky on the damage spread. But the minimum damage was 5, so yeah, he will die. And we shredded the other one. We might be able to kill the other one. What's Bob's chance to hit? Oh, 19% only, right. That is slightly too low. And we don't have combat protocol anymore. Speaking of breaking that overwatch though, we can just use interference, I suppose, so let's do that. And the best part about interference is that it doesn't end your turn. It would be kind of useless if it did end your turn. I probably wouldn't bother with it if it ended your turn. And we'll just use walk fire to try finishing off the sergeant, I guess. RIP.
X-ray neutralized.
So now, the sectoid. I can't do much about the sectoid, I guess. That interference was pretty useless. But hey, we used it anyway, whatever. Let's set up with steady weapon. And I guess that's that. Not much point using aid protocol. There's no one to really use it on. We'll move slightly closer and overwatch. See what the sectoid is going to do. He might raise another zombie. What is he doing? Oh, Psy panic again. Yeah, that's fine. Lot is gone, but I wasn't really planning to get that pile. It was way too dangerous. 50%. Let's just use precision shot, why the heck not? And we missed. Oh well. You tried. We'll just take a few shots and hopefully we'll hit eventually. I know that's not the most exciting plan of all times, but we got things like walk fire, hail of bullets, and so on. No more combat protocol, but surely we'll hit it or at least graze it eventually. And then we can just use hail of bullets, for example.
On your order.
He has loot, so I'm not going to use explosives. I'd like the loot. There we go, 7 damage. We might even be able to kill it on this turn. Can we do that? Let's have a look. I don't think we are close enough. No, we are close enough. And hail of bullets is off cooldown. So that's basically it, it's dead. And I think we're done. Unless there's one more group.
That's right. This might be useful. Positive confirmation.
No, we are actually done, nice.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
That was a pretty damn good mission. Flawless. That's what I like to see. Dealt most damage, Bob. Bob is slowly becoming the MVP not just of one or two missions, but this entire damn campaign. No promotions, unfortunately. Oh well. These guys were all fairly high rank. But I hope we'll get our first gunnery sergeant sometime soon. So, here's our first elite laser sight. We got plus 4 defense PCS, plus 8 psi offense, and advanced expanded magazine. We also got 40 supplies, 8 alarium, 9 alloys, and a few corpses. Definitely useful. Alright then. Training for Gordon is almost done. So now, building the relay. We got lightning hands on Gordon. That's his first one. Let's check Gordon's training again. What else can he get? It would be nice to get face-off for him. So let's have a look. Where's Gordon? Christian, Delta. What about Delta? Grazing fire, return fire, will to survive. Now, where is Gordon? Right here. He's just a corporal, but yeah, face-off is nice. Face-off it is then. It's only 6 days. Back to the bridge. And there's the relay. So we do actually have enough intel to start making contact with New Indonesia. It's just that we need to move one of the gremlins. Which isn't a big deal, I'm not actually doing anything in the Proving Ground. Let's check the Proving Ground, actually. We got 369 supplies right now, which really isn't that much. Battlefield medicine, yeah, 100 supplies, that's so expensive. I think we should get skull mining, though. Yeah, we kind of really should. Out of all these things on the list, we need skull mining the most, I would say. And also blue screen protocol, but we need advent makerec for that. Okay, skull mining it is then. It pains me to spend 150 supplies on that, but oh well. New target acquired. Light activity, 2 days, 10 hours. Yeah, we won't be doing that. Not really. There's not enough time. Okay, carry on. And how's that other mission? 200%, right, so I guess we'll be doing the network tower in the next episode. Thanks for watching this one, I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.